How do you like my haircut?
It's nice.
Yeah, a little long, but I like it.
I can't wait to dig into this pot.
Oh, no, not yet. We promise we wait for Big Bird, remember? No.
Yeah. Harry, Monica, I'm coming.
That's him, I think.
I think, too.
Hi, Monica.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hi, Harry. Hey, look, I'm wearing my pie tie.
Pie tie?
I always wear this tie whenever I eat pie. And how do you like it?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know either.
You don't know? Well, oh, no. Oh, I forgot. You can't see.
No.
Oh, gee, well, then how are you going to know about my tie if you can't see it?
Oh, yeah, there are other ways, Big Bird.
Really?
Yeah. Right, Monica?
Right.
You see, there are different ways you can tell about things without seeing them.
Oh? Well, how?
Sit down and I'll tell you about it. There's lots of different ways, Big Bird. Let me see. I know.
Monica and I, we cannot see the sky. We cannot see a flower or someone's brand new tie. No, Monica and I can't see an apple pie, but we learn about things in other ways. It's really not a problem. Here is why. We can feel things with our fingers, and noses know exactly how to smell. And mouths can tell you lots about how things taste, and we hear as clear as a bell. And the sky is filled with singing birds, and a bunch of flowers smell so sweet. And your tie feels smooth and soft and silky, and this apple pie tastes wonderful to eat.
Yeah.
And Monica and I have so much still to try, and the world is rich and full and fine. We're living, laughing, loving, flying high, Monica and I, Monica and I.
Gee, I think I understand, because there's lots of ways to know about things without seeing.
Exactly, Big Bird. What color is your tie?
Well, it's really very many colors. It's got lots of colors.
Yeah.
Part of this is raspberry. It's the last pie I had. But overall, it's polyester.
Polyester?
You never have to press it.
Ah, well, that's lucky.
Yeah.
Boy, I sure get hungry thinking about that last raspberry pie. How about getting some apple pie on it?
Yay! Well, we got her here all ready to go.
Okay,
see,
you cut.
Where's the knife? Oh, boy, oh, boy.
There we go. That looks just fine. Now, let's see. Tripod's the right level. Camera. Okay, let's check. Oh, no, I can't believe this. I forgot the most important thing.
Hi, Olivia.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Doing some picture-taking stuff, huh?
Yes, I've got to take a picture of this arrangement here. Listen, I forgot something very important. Oh. Do you think you could watch my camera for me while I run up to my room to get it?
Oh, would I? Why, you're talking to the old watchbird himself.
Oh, great. I'll just be a minute, okay?
Okay. This is a watchbird watching the camera.
Hello, bird.
Oh, hi, Mr. Snuffleupagus. Hey, is it great that you came along right now? Because you're going to meet one of my friends. She just went into the building, but she's going to come right out. So if you just stick around a few minutes, you're going to meet Olivia.
Oh, gee, I'd love to wait, bird. But I just can't. I'm due at my gymnastics class in 5 minutes.
Oh, that's too far to wait. Isn't that a long walk? Well, I've got a great idea, Snuffy.
What?
Look, I'm sure Olivia wouldn't mind if I snapped just one picture with her camera here, a picture of you. So then all my friends will know you're real.
Oh, Bert, you have the best bird brains in the whole world.
Oh, I know. Now, get ready. I'm going to see if I can line up the camera. Focus it here. Mm-hmm. Okay, get ready to say cheese.
Could I say spaghetti instead?
Well, if you must. Get ready.
Spaghetti.
Oh, I think I got it. Oh, boy. I'm a photographer.
Oh, very good, Bert. But I really gotta go now.
Oh, okay, Snuffy.
Bye,
have a good time.
Bye.
Oh, but this is great. At last, I got a picture of my best pal, and now everybody's gonna know he's real.
Oh, thank you, Big Bird.
Oh, Olivia, I'm so excited. You won't believe what happened while you were gone.
What happened?
Well, I hope you don't mind, but I just snapped one picture of my friend Mr. Snuffleupagus so that you're going to know he's real. Now, when you get this film developed, you'll see this picture of a Snuffleupagus smiling at you.
Big Bird, I don't think it's going to work that way.
Why not?
Well, I forgot something very important.
Like what?
Well, the film. There was no film in the camera. It was empty. And you know what that means.
No picture.
Aha, finished. That's pretty good. Huh? I gotta show this to somebody. I want to show this poem to somebody.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Robert Louis Stevenson, Louis. How's it going, Mr. Nimblefingers? You written anything immortal recently?
Okay, well, you can laugh, Oscar, but I'm very serious about my writing, all right? As a matter of fact, I just got through writing a poem.
Yeah?
Yeah. Wanted to show it to somebody, but nobody here.
Oh, what am I? Wood? I'll read your poem for you.
Oh, no, no, no. I know better than to let you read my poem. Besides, I know that you and I would not see eye to eye on poetry.
Oh, I see. You're only interested in showing it to someone who'll say, gee, this is wonderful, Luis.
Oh, not really, but I mean, I know that you're a grouch and you just like grouchy things.
Well, if you just want to be patted on the back, then just find another guy. But if you want an unbiased, impartial, fair reading of your work, well, I'm your grouch. I mean, man.
Okay, okay, okay. You can read it, all right?
Okay.
You can read it. Wait a minute. What'd I do with it? Oh, I left it back at the fix-it shop. Never mind. Never mind.
Hey, no, no. I'm with you, pal. Why don't we just go back to your store and take a look at it, huh? Come on.
If you insist.
Poker writing poem. Whoop, wrong key. Oh, this is not easy. Oh, Louis coming back. Better scram.
Well, there it is, Oscar.
Where? In the typewriter?
Right there, yeah, typewriter. Okay. Dying to see how you like it.
Yeah, me too. Let's see here. Hey, looks good already. Yeah, hey, I didn't think you had it in you, but this is first rate, Louis. Yeah, I really like this. Yeah, I like a part here that says, Blur, throb, foof, smorg, ilberg, snurg, diggledorf, triggle, snurk, fernort, ex, grinder, slurk, perfoink, galunk, argle, drex, trop off.
Wait a minute.
See? Good stuff.
That's not what I wrote.
It's not?
No.
You didn't write that?
No.
Well, too bad, because I got to tell you, Whoever wrote that is some sort of poetic genius.
Poco genius, poco genius.
Okay, you guys, you've had your little joke. But this is the poem that I wrote right here.
Oh, you found it, eh?
Yeah.
And now I suppose you're going to read it to us, too, huh?
Well, you did say you wanted to hear it.
Yeah, me and my big mouth.
I call it Autumn. Leaves of gold, of silver, of bronze, fall gently from the trees. We walk along the path, unaware of the treasure at our feet. Huh? What do you think?
Well, you want to tell him?
Yeah, you tell him.
Okay. Well, to be perfectly honest with you, Luis, I think your poem is pretty rotten.
Rotten?
Yeah, but Poco Locos was even more rotten. So, all in all, I think I like his better.
my better.
Hey, look, put another piece of paper in there. I got something for you to type. Yeah. Okay. Get ready to type these letters for you. Like, Sesame Street is brought to you today by the letters B and J and by the number 4. Yeah, hey, that's good typing, Luis. Much better than your poem. Sesame Street, type that, is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. I'll make you into a poet yet, Luis.